Hey everybody, Julian here. In this video, I'm going to give you a few quick and easy tips that will help in getting better results when you're recording a musical performance onto a computer. You might be making a video to share on YouTube or your socials, recording a performance from home for an audition or academic submission, or even using a video conferencing app like Skype or Zoom to share a performance or music lesson. Whatever your scenario, this video will help you capture all the nuances of your performance. The first step in delivering a good result is to use an external microphone. The microphones in smartphones and laptops are generally not very high quality and are usually only designed to record speech, albeit not very well. By simply using an external microphone to record your performance, the quality of your audio will dramatically improve. The easiest way to do this is with a USB microphone. These plug directly into your computer with no complicated interfaces or additional recording equipment required. There are quite a few USB microphones in the Rode range and they will all deliver an incredible result. But the microphone that I'm going to use today is the NT USB Mini, which is perfect for this application as it sounds great in a wide variety of situations and is very easy to use. But the information in this video applies to all of the USB microphones in our range, including the VideoMic NTG, the original NT-USB, and of course the Podcaster. There's no need to install any software or drivers. Your computer will automatically detect the microphone. This will actually work the same on both Windows and Mac computers. The next step is to ensure the software that you are using recognizes the NT-USB Mini as the audio input source. Whether you are using Zoom, GarageBand, Logic Pro, or Skype, the process is very similar. Look in the settings for audio settings or audio input and ensure that the NT-USB Mini is selected. If you're also using headphones, for example, if you're on a video call, you can connect these to the headphone output on the back of the NT-USB Mini. To ensure that you're connected properly, you'll need to go back to the audio settings and this time look for the audio output setting. And make sure this is also set to the NT-USB Mini. Remember, you can adjust the volume of your headphones using the volume control on the front of the mic. Now, just that alone will improve the quality of your audio considerably, even if you just leave the mic on the desk next to your computer. But with a bit of thought about microphone placement, you can get an incredible result even at home. The first thing to consider is the room that you are in. Generally speaking, you will get a much better result in a room that has less echo. In everyday life, we tend not to notice how much echo there is in rooms such as kitchens or living rooms. But in a recording, it suddenly becomes very obvious and distracting. This is why professional recording studios have acoustic treatment to reduce this. Of course, very few of us have a sound-treated studio at home, but by simply moving from a kitchen to a lounge room or bedroom can make a huge difference. Rooms with less hard surfaces and more soft furnishings will sound much better. So moving to a carpeted bedroom will really help to add clarity to your recording. The next thing to consider is microphone placement. If you're recording your own voice, whether singing or speaking, getting up really close to the microphone will deliver a very professional sound. Aim to be about 20 centimeters away from the microphone. To get the sound that you're looking for, you can experiment with getting closer or further away from the microphone. You can easily check how you sound by wearing the headphones that you have connected into the back of the NT-USB Mini and activating the zero latency monitoring function. You do this by pressing in on the volume control. Zero latency monitoring sounds very complicated, but all it does is allow you to hear what the mic is picking up directly in your headphones. This is great for monitoring your audio, especially if you're singing and you want to clearly hear how your performance is being captured. Now, if you're recording an acoustic instrument like a guitar, place the mic a little further away and make sure it's pointed at your instrument. Pointing the mic at the center of your instrument is usually a very good place to start and will generally give you a nicely balanced result. But you can also experiment with different positions to see how it affects the sound. And finally, if you're recording an electric instrument, it's usually best to place the mic about 10 centimeters in front of the amp or speaker to capture a clean sound. These simple steps will really help lift your recording quality and deliver a professional result with very little effort. If you want to go further and learn about using more audio tools, tips for microphone placement, and other more advanced techniques, check out the links to our other videos and blogs below. But if you just want to get a great result with minimal effort, follow these tips that will really help make your performance stand out. Thanks everybody, and happy recording.